artistic director, Pamela Grundy.
Thank you. There's an awful lot I couldn't cram into this 2-minute speech, but here we go. When I met Danny, he was 33. Handsome, sinewy, a racehorse of a dancer. Pretty new to Canada at that time. The country fell in love with the shaggy-haired, bandy-legged rebel as he set the stage on fire with his astonishing first work called Higher. Through astute body wisdom and unique gifts as an extraordinary dancer, he created a fresh and unusual, for the time, dance language that made the Canadian dance community sit up and take notice. From the spiritual to the decadent, the humorous to the poignant, his finely chiseled works of art relate to the human condition. He grew up in a politically charged household in San Francisco. His parents were tireless social activists, and much from Danny's repertoire carries on the work that his parents devoted their lives to. Through this segment of his choreography, he pays homage to the social outcasts, the underdogs, the innocent victims, and puts political leaders, corporate bosses, and the far right under the microscope. He had little interest in being part of an art elite. More than anything, he wanted to show his work to the broadest slice of humanity as possible. He played the world stages, but relished in bringing his art to those who he thought needed it the most. Danny silenced a crowded gymnasium of rowdy inmates at the Drumheller prison because they saw themselves in his solitary, tortured figure trapped in a circus ring. During the Dade County, Florida school show in 1976, he performed his satirical statement on American politics, National Spirit. He was escorted out of the building by a sheriff and an angry teacher who exclaimed, "It'll take me 10 years to undo what you just did." Particularly poignant on this weekend of the Great March. And let's not forget that beginning in the 1970s, his overtly gay-themed works broke barriers on concert stages across Canada and worldwide. So Danny, on behalf of the whole dance community, we thank you for your artistry. We thank you for your leadership, and most of all, for standing up for what you believe in, on and off the stage. Thank you.
You know, when I first had to use one of these, I was doing a lecture demo with Paul Taylor. And after we did it, we'd sit on the stage. And everyone would tell the audience, "My name is Liz Walton. I was born in Baltimore, blah, blah." And I was always at the end of the line. By the time the microphone was handed to me, I said, ever since then, I've been extremely frightened that will happen again. So I had a whole speech that if I tried to have done it, my voice would have shaped. So I'll skip that. Except when Pam said the principal, when she said, "It'll take me 10 years to unteach what you just showed me," I said, I had never received a greater compliment. Now, I didn't really immigrate to Canada, because to so many Americans, San Francisco was never considered a part of the United States. In fact, then I went to New York City, which was also never considered a part of the United States. Then I went to Canada, and I've been here 45 years. All of my work was created here in Toronto, period. So I really just migrated like a bird or an animal to a place I loved, which happened to be Toronto. I met Lawrence and Miriam Adams, late 1970s, at 15 Dance Lab on George Street. They may have been living in that building at the time. I don't think they had the house yet on that street. They filmed a work of mine. I've kept touch with Miriam, my buddy, ever since. So for this award to be initiated by Lawrence and Miriam's work and in Toronto is a lifelong to me. Thank you.